Hello, the following is the Pyramid of Learning, also known as Bloom's Taxonomy. It's a useful tool for understanding and using for your learning. It covers six different levels, beginning at knowledge, comprehension, application, analysis, synthesis, and finally evaluation. Knowledge is placed at the bottom because it really is the first step. Whenever you read a text, teachers will often ask knowledge questions. They'll ask you to tell, or list, or describe, or locate, or find particular kinds of information. Most tests, including standardized tests, like the TOEFL, ask knowledge questions. They're relatively easy. You can see that the sample question stems. How many can you find? What is? These are all knowledge-based questions. The next level is comprehension. Let me scroll down here. In comprehension, it's a little bit harder, and some useful verbs to describe it are to explain or interpret, to outline or to discuss, and you can use see the sample question stems. What do you think, or what is the main idea? Can you distinguish between? These are useful tools for understanding the text. A more difficult level is the third one of application. Here you're trying to solve or to show or to illustrate, to examine the information. The sample question stems imply these kinds of ideas as well. What questions would you ask of here? Do you know another instance where you're trying to apply it to another situation? These three areas provide most of the information, most of the questions that you find on standardized tests. But they're also very helpful in your reading because you're wanting to understand the basics of the material. The next set of analysis, synthesis, and evaluation go further into a text and are really more the area of critical thinking. So under analysis, we look at which events could have happened, how is this similar to where you're doing a comparison, where you're doing a comparison of ideas. Comparison and contrast is also an analysis. Can you compare your ideas with what was presented in something else? So you're contrasting. So you don't just simply categorize, which you can do simply in a comprehension or knowledge, but you're actually trying to compare the ideas between this. Synthesis goes even to a greater depth, where you're pulling together information, where you can see where you're creating information, where you're constructing or designing or planning. You're bringing complex ideas together. So if you're composing a song about a topic, that would certainly do that. Can you create new and unusual uses for something? What happened if? This is sort of a hypothetical situation. And finally, the last area is evaluation. You can see by these words that they're oftentimes relating to defending information. So you're judging, you're choosing, you're justifying, you're debating, you're arguing. This all occurs in the realm of evaluation. And you can see that in doing those things, one is likely to use a great deal of critical thinking. Now, when you approach reading, most of the time, you're going to be in the lower levels, knowledge, comprehension, and application, sometimes analysis. These higher things are much more into deeper levels of critical thinking. All of these levels or steps in the period of learning can really help your learning try to apply these as much as you can when you read new texts and when you evaluate material.
Wow.